several events that it does not seem. So, if you need to communicate with someone about a number of different things, consider writing a separate email on each subject. That way, your correspondent can reply to each one individually and in an appropriate time frame. One topic might only require a short reply that he or she can send straight away. Another topic might require more research. By writing separate messages, you should get clear answers. By making other people manage their inboxes better. If you want to put several points in an email, perhaps because they relate to the same project, consider presenting each point in a separate number paragraph. This makes each point stand out significantly, increasing the likelihood that each point will be addressed.
All right. Now, why is this a green underline all through? So where is the mistake? Read it.
As with the traditional business letters, each individual email should be clear and concise, with the purpose of the message related in the very first paragraph.
So where is the mistake here in the grammar?
As
with the traditional business letters, each individual email should be clear and concise, with the purpose of message detailed in the very first paragraph. Where is the grammar mistake? I want you to identify the grammar mistake. How will you identify the grammar mistake? You can see here, there is also a grammar mistake. Why is that? What you do is, when you find a grammar mistake, alright? What does it give? It gives you a prompt. Now, reply which. Now, which one is correct? Either I need to remove this comma or add which. With reply that, which he or she. Which is correct? Or that is correct? Reply that is correct.
Which
he or she can send straight away. Which he or she can send right away. Clear? So what I need to do is click this. Is your green mark gone? That means the grammar is correct now. It's between two confusing letters, that and which. The computer is so intelligent that it prompts you that there is a grammar mistake. Clear? Well, so much of support is there given by your machine itself. Why rate stupid names without grammar? Clear? Now, where is the grammar mistake over here? Alright? What does it say? What does it say? Fragment. Consider revising. Alright? It's telling that it's a grammar problem. Correct? Now let's see what we can do over here. Now what happened? With only insertion of one comma, alright, you saw the green lines vanishing. Yes? And why this red has come over here? It's a space. Correct? Now if I put a space, there will be further green lines appearing from somewhere. Clear? Let me give the space. Alright, is the grammar correct now? No? बना के. ग्रामर ओके. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस वन कॉमा एंड द वर्ड एज, राइट? सो इफ यू स्टार्ट विद समथिंग व्हिच इज रॉन्ग, योर एंटायर पैराग्राफ बिकम्स रॉन्ग, इट गिव्स अ रॉन्ग मीनिंग. यस, टेक टाइम टू सेंड योर ईमेल्स, डू नॉट बी इन अ हरी, राइट? Because people will look down upon you. They say, what nonsense these people are sending. You can't even be respected because writing is an important art which you need to learn. Now you saw the entire grammar became okay with the removal of as and insertion of a comma. Clear? Then let's look at another bad example, bad email. All right, read this.
Subject.
All together.
Subject. Revision for sales report. Hi Jati. Thanks for sending me that report last week. I read it to you yesterday and feel that you need more specific information regarding our sales figures in chapter 2. I also felt that the report could be a little more formal. The report is going to be ready by our security and we need to prepare our professional system. Also, I wanted to let you know that I have scheduled a meeting with the PR department for this Friday regarding the new ad campaign.
It's at 11:30
and I'm in the small conference room. Please let me know if you can make it.
What's it? Is it it's a bad example. Where do you find it bad? Sorry? Alright? AM mark here. Why is the green mark there? It's a grammar mistake. F should be in? I don't know. Let me just check. What is it showing? Who had put all the caps after a full stop? But who started it? Alright? But will not start. In between caps was where? For every letter there was a capital letter used. Do not use capital letters for every letter. When are the capital letters used? Can you repeat your grammar to me? After a full stop, beginning of the sentence, when you proper nouns, proper nouns. Whenever you use a proper noun, it starts with a capital letter. Right? Beginning of a paragraph,
name.
That's proper noun. What's, what are the proper nouns? Names you told me. What are the proper nouns? Tell me your first noun. What is a noun? What is a noun? Water. What is a noun? So what is a proper noun? What are, what is noun and what's a proper noun? What are abstract nouns? What are nouns? What are proper nouns? What are common nouns? What are abstract nouns? Oh, taking back to 5th standard, see, your basic fundamentals should be so strong. What is taught to you in your standard 5th comes throughout your life. Like mathematics, which is taught to you, you will use it throughout your life. That's your fundamentals. What's your fundamental? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Right? You will use it throughout your life. Similarly, the grammar is used throughout your life. When you want to teach your brother's children or your children, will you teach them a wrong grammar? Would you like to teach them a wrong grammar? Then why do you write a wrong grammar? Will your parents teach you a wrong grammar? Will your teachers teach you a wrong grammar? No. Then why are you people writing it? Are you not ashamed to write the grammar in a wrong way? You're all knowledgeable, literate people. Shall I use that word or shall I use you're all educated word? They're literate or educated? Literate. Then if you are educated, then you should know all these things. Correct? This is your basic which is taught to you for 10 years in your school. And you have forgotten about it. Please take care about the grammar. Yeah? Clear? Alright. Let us analyze what was bad in this. Yeah. Read this. That is a continuation. Monica. Alright.
Monica got a and she was pretty clear about the changes she followed and that she made before. But what did she do wrong? Well, the second paragraph about the meaning is pretty important. And yet she jumped quickly to a recommendation that he made in her wishes. If Jackie does not stay in her calendar, she will have to remember that the meaning details were in the meeting of the title. Vision for space is good, which is not very logical. Combining those two important communications increases the chance that later the meeting or the vision will be forgotten.
This is in inverted commas, correct? What does it state? It states a first person, alright, straight, direct voice. That's why I put somebody yesterday, I sent a mail by putting inverted commas. Yeah? That means it's a repetition of what is told. Revision 4. So this is small f. And why this? Huh? It's not jump, it is lump. Lumped means putting it together. She has lumped it. Alright, what's a lump? It's like a boil on you. That's a lump. When so you hit something, you get a lump, right? So she has lumped it. What does the grammar say? Verb confusion. Alright? So what should it do? What it should be? It's a verb confusion there. When you have your subject, your verb, and your agreement. I think I told you this. Subject, verb, and agreement is very important in every sentence which is possible. Correct? So if you don't take care of your subject, verb, and agreement, your entire meaning changes. So you have a subject, but the verb is confused. Clear? So what should we put there? Let's see. Alright, let's see the good example and see what can be done. Alright, the same I have done a mistake here. So it is for, alright, read the good example.
Revision for CS report. Hi Jackie, thanks for sending me that report of ours. I read it yesterday and feel that you need more specific information regarding our sales figures in the chapter 2. I also felt that the door could be a little more formal. The door is going to be made by our professional team and needs to interact all our professionals. Thanks for your hard work on this.
Then? Does it give the entire meaning?
Nobody will say anything.
Yes?
It was on the last one, people will shout.
So where is the verb which she has used here?
You have to just give them some time.
What's the second paragraph? What has she lumped?
Next also.
The second. Also, I wanted to let you know that I have scheduled a meeting with PR department for this Friday regarding the new ad campaign. It is at 11. Alright? And we'll be in a small conference room. What has she done? She has jumbled up everything. Alright? So, it's a jumble. Correct? There's no specific timing. Alright? Small conference room. Right? PR department. Ad campaign. New ad campaign. Which nobody knows about. So she has jumbled up everything. I have used the word lump. Lump is not a verb. Alright? You need to use a right kind of verb there. What's a verb we can use? Jumbled. Right? So you can put that word jumbled, it gets changed. Clear? So you need to be very careful about the verb. Alright, specific response you want. Reason.
This is important. He's saying nothing.
Together.
Now he will send. You go now. So what happened? You go in the other room.
Make sure you include your
incident reporting, correct? Use a clear subject matter, raise your ticket, give the reference number of your ticket, alright? And say that you will work on this problem and revert. Use the word revert, right? Don't say get back. Am I clear? And once you close your ticket, please send it to your customer telling that you have worked on his reference ticket, so and so. And these are the steps you have followed for solving this problem. And after the solution, please put a screenshot of your work done and send it across. Clear? And acknowledge, thank, ask him if everything is okay, and thank him also. Clear? How do you say thank you?
Thank him.
Thanks and regards. Or regards. Alright?